Hi guys, welcome back to Niche Story Mode. In the last episode, I think Adam had a really vivid bad dream when he hit the floor. So let's go with that instead of what actually happened. Like I said, I'm not that good at this game. So, Adam is stranded, dropped by a bird, just had a vision of the future, or an alternate reality, let's call it. Definitely didn't fail, definitely didn't lose, definitely didn't go extinct. Definitely not. Nope. I don't know what you're talking about. So let's get to the port. Let's travel. Let's get Facebook messages every time. If I was a better editor, I would add like a Facebook messenger noise counter. Yeah, I hear that. We've been through this. Adam knows what to do now. See, he knows right where she is. Look at her this time. I always do that. Okay, let's get a good look at Eve. She's got spiky body. She's got double nimble fingers. Short-sighted, recessive, and big ears, recessive. Big body. No weird webbed legs. Anywhere? No? I'm gonna go ahead and give Adam the regular eyes just because he does have the short-sighted recessive. Let's pass on the day and he grows up right before her eyes. I feel like she's like, wow, that's amazing. Okay. So Adam and Eve are together on this island and I feel like she's gonna show him how to pick food for himself and you know, around on her little island. He's right up on the bunny burrow, attacking moles, and she's just looking over in amazement. She's never seen anyone attack moles that quickly. She's always been stuck to the berries and the nuts, because with double nimble fingers, that's easy for her. Like I said in the very first episode, I'm gonna give my nichelings a story. Just so that there's something a little extra. So I feel like Eve is pretty impressed with Adam, and they get along well, so they'll become mates and start expecting their first child. Adam, being the protective mate he is, will probably clear the crap. Oh! Okay! I wasn't expecting that on the first go. As I was saying, Adam, being the protective mate he is and the curious nicheling, will probably clear the grass and try his own hand at collecting a nut, like he watched Eve, but was interrupted by my cat and his twin sons, Dukir and Nuvanvan. Oh, okay. Well, let's take a look at them. Both of them carry the necessary traits to be leader, however, Nuvanvan has the short-sighted eye. So I'm going to give it to his brother Dukir, the leader of the title of future tribe leader, and that could cause some sibling rivalry later on, who knows. Other than that, they seem to be fairly identical as far as genetics go. I mean, obviously their color is different. And the eyesight, and I think the tail recessive, so they are fraternal twins, but twins nonetheless, which I was not expecting, and that definitely caught me off guard. Good start. I'm gonna start off by naming them. So Dukir, let me pull up the names list. I feel like this is my redemption from the last episode, where I actually didn't pay attention to hunger enough and all my creatures starved to death, essentially. And I couldn't pass on the genes in time. And they all just died. I'm gonna give them plant names because, you know, Eve is very close to this island. She probably came from an island where they're herbivores and just very gentle creatures. So I'm gonna name you Gorse and your brother. I mean, well, he's pink, so I'm gonna name him Rose. So there's Gorse and Rose, Eve's two beloved twin sons. She's a very excited, very overprotective mother of her sons, very nurturing, very caring, because she's from a tribe where nurturing and caring is just part of their culture, whereas Adam doesn't know too much about his tribe in this go-through. He was taken too young to really know, but he does remember the large red trees. So he's sitting here telling his sons all about their roots and his story and even his strange dream, although Eve is probably a little skeptical about the dream. I'm gonna have her scooch over here so that she can collect some nuts. This is the end of the tutorial. Yep, we've been through there. We've been there, done that. And the two boys are... Right now, they're curious little boys. I mean, what is there to say? Eve wants more children immediately. Just one second. The cat is yowling, and I'm not sure what he wants, so I can't control him. So if there's any meowing in the background, that's who it is. Eve wants more children, as many children as possible, although realistically, Adam is telling her, you know, there's only so much food on this island, and you don't want to wear yourself out. I mean, he wants to go and find home. He wants to go find his home island, and Eve's happy staying here with her children. She just wants to have lots and lots of babies. We've got another boy, Nuro, who's got better eyesight than his older brothers, but he doesn't carry the home island immunity. So just another nicheling. Gorse is still the one who carries the title of tribe leader. I'm gonna name Nuro something plant related. Let's name him. There it is again. Let's name him. Let's let Adam name him, actually. So something not plant related, something that reminds Adam of his home. So he's going to be named Shade. I feel like that's fair. You've got to name the first two. And Adam's probably, you know, like teaching his family all about Eve too, because Eve is, you know, a nurturing good mother. But they're teaching their family all about how to survive and collect food and all that good stuff. Eve is coming over here. I think she smells something in the water. And they're just teaching them life lessons. Little Shade can get in, and his brothers are showing him how to collect berries and how to kick trees for nuts. Adam is still trying to get to the nut himself, while Eve is over here looking into the water. And she finds a clam, and she decides to dig around a little bit. So maybe she's educating her family that, hey, there's food in the water. They come in shells. You just gotta pick them up and break them open. Free. Everyone's getting better. Shade's gonna try his hand at collecting berries from this bush. And Gorse is gonna claim this bush, and Adam is still working on his nut. He got it though, so I feel like he feels a sense of accomplishment, and he's like, okay, I'm done here, let's get going. Rose can follow. Eve's all the way over here and a little bit slow, but she makes it too. And the other two. I mean, Gorse is the leader, so he's a little bit practical in being like, we should collect what food we can before we leave. She's totally right. Rose can get on the port and try digging in the water like his mom suggested. Can you collect the seaweed? Yep, so Eve has discovered that the water is a great source of food. Even if, you know, they're not designed for it. They don't have webbed paws or claws for fishing or anything. Gorse is gonna stand up. And his brother has collected the last of the berries. Everything? Anything? Anything at all? Any food? No. Okay. Gorse, lead us to our new island. So this time, in the last one, in Adam's dream, he had three daughters, and he lost his mate Eve because she chose to stay behind. This time, he has three sons and a loving mate. But she has a fascination with the water, I feel like, and she's just really wants to explore the depths and see all the different things like there can be. Gorse will, I feel, take the lead in clearing out the grass, and his brother Rose, who is also sort of a rival, because he doesn't understand why he's not the chosen one, because he has the same things as his brother, but he doesn't realize that he has worse eyesight. But I think all the Adam and Eve will be very proud of their children and how they've jumped right into their new island and their new territory, and it's got two trees. No comment. But they're very proud of their children and how responsible they all are, even though I feel like Rose is starting to get a little bit jealous of his older twin brother. Shade has found a berry bush, which I think Eve will go over and start collecting from. And there's a little fish. It's just... Eve will feel right at home there because she loves the ocean. Just trying to clear out the grass. See if I can find anything interesting, such as a permanist or maybe a female. Or another berry bush, I guess, works. Poor Eve, she's so torn between her family and the ocean. She doesn't go in it though. She's smart enough not to. I feel like she'll get leached though, and her interest will be greatly lost. Adam's giving his sons a hunting lesson there. They're all continuing to explore and uncover the world around them, their new territory. Shade goes a little bit over here. As far as personalities go, I'm gonna cover this right now. Eve, as I said, is probably very nurturing and caring and kind-hearted. Adam is reasonable and level-headed. Rose is desperate to prove himself as worthy and a little bit jealous. Gorse is confident and headstrong and just has a natural leader's personality, and Shade is a little bit distant. Maybe he's just a little bit more independent than the rest of his family, but all of their attributes will work together nicely to form a nice story, hopefully. I hope I can do it. I'm not good at storytelling, really. Eve is keen on feeding her family, while Adam is keen on helping his sons uncover the grass to make sure everything's safe. Rose's gone over there probably to shop his brother as the explorer, while Shade is over here doing his own thing. And Eve sees another clam in the water, so she's gonna actually step into the water and see the fish. She sees the fish, she's gonna go for the clam. That disappeared. Okay. She's not gonna go to the clam, but she's in the water now. So maybe she's having more fun in there. She can keep digging for worms. She's actually really good at that. Shade can catch this mole, collect a little bit of meat. Adam can once again try and imitate his mate and fail. And I feel like Gorse is finally pleased with the territory that they've cleared out. And he thinks he's deemed the island is safe. There's no permanents, but I did hear a sneeze. Did anyone else hear the sneeze? Interesting. Look at this. There's even a nut in the water. It's like Eve's calling. Does she have a water tail? She does. She has a swimming tail. Eve was meant to be an aquatic nicheling. Oh. So while Adam was focusing on this nut, I think he saw something. And I feel like he called out and Rose is the first one to go and investigate and find a little female. Rhianara, right? Rhianara? Rhianara. She's not the healthiest, but let's invite her in because it's better to have her here helping us than stealing from us. And Goris is probably quite cross with his brother for rushing after an unknown creature like that. Probably because he wanted to do it himself. Let's pass on the day. And I'm a little worried she's going to pass her sickness on, so I'm going to move her in. And I'm also going to leave this episode here. So we've got the three sons, the wandering female, Rhianara, Adam and Eve, who are enjoying their old age, but Eve is getting older than Adam, so I'm gonna move her over here into the flowers so that she can pass away among the flowers next to her mate and the sea, which she loves. Thank you so much for watching, and if you liked this video, leave a like or a comment to support me, or if you want to see more of my stuff, you know, subscribe to my channel or come hang out with me on social media. Links are in the description. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!